Hey guys, Level Cap here, and today is Monday, which means it's time for an episode of Loadout, the series where you guys get to pick my gun and configuration for each episode. Just leave a comment in the comment section of this episode letting me know what kind of gun and accessories you'd like me to run with, and I will pick one of the top-rated comments for the next episode. Today's top comment comes from Petrified Squid, who suggests playing the support class, running with the MK3A1, Iron Sights, Extended Magazines, 12-gauge Slugs, C4 Explosives. I've never seen you do a review of the MK3A1. I can understand this, as it's not very effective when you first unlock it, but the Slugs really buff this gun, increasing the damage to 75, making for a 2-3 hit kills, or even a cheeky headshot. Don't hold down the trigger, I know it's tempting, as it's a fully automatic, but the spread will get out of control. Handle this weapon with caution. Now, in previous episodes, I have explained my loathe for the slugs with shotguns because they don't bother changing the targeting reticle from a circle to a crosshair. You still have the circle targeter, which makes sense for a scatter gun, but for a gun that's shooting one slug, a crosshair makes much more sense, and it becomes so much harder to aim with the circle targeter. Now, I will say that putting slugs in an auto shotgun is a very interesting augmentation, because yes, you do 75 top damage, which means it's still a one-shot headshot in close quarters, so this thing can be very, very lethal if your aiming is top-notch. And again, coming back to that circle targeter, it's kind of hard to have top-notch aiming with this kind of targeting device, like going for the head. I'm almost tempted to like put a little piece of tape or something in the very center of my screen just so that I can hip fire with this kind of shotgun. I'm sure that's what any sort of serious player would actually do. It's what you did back in the day with Counter-Strike and stuff to get those hip fire shots and stuff like that, if they don't provide you with a crosshair on your screen. Now, alternatively, you can aim down sights, but as you can see here, the aiming down sights with this gun with using the iron sights is atrocious. Why did you suggest using iron sights with this gun? Anything, a Cobra red dot sight would have been so much more preferable than using the iron sights. The iron sights kind of take up practically your whole screen there, so it's very easy to lose your target. Now, once you've equipped the extended mags on this weapon, you can get up to 13 rounds available. That includes the one in the chamber, 12 rounds if you don't have one in the chamber. And this is a lot of ammunition to work with, especially considering that one of these shots can take down your opponent if you headshot them in close quarters. You can almost compare this gun to a slightly faster firing Magnum with the same ability to one-shot headshot in close quarters. You will have less accurate hipfire though. Now, if you miss that headshot, you are going to have to land another body shot. 75 damage in close quarters is definitely something that can drop people in one shot if they are hurt just a little bit. So that actually will happen to you a lot. Somebody will already have 25 or 30 damage done to them, and you'll just one-shot body shot them, which is always a great feeling. You don't have to worry about those headshots. Landing multiple shots though with this gun can be a little bit tricky. The reliability of it, unless your aim is top-notch, is very difficult. You know, I felt a lot of situations where if I had some sort of automatic weapon, I could have really guaranteed my kills, and with this gun I was sort of like, I hope it kills this guy, because each shot you're sort of waiting for it to land, relying on it to land, and if you miss one or two of those critical shots, you're going down. Whereas with an assault rifle, you either have to be completely off target, or if you're on target, then you know your opponent's going down extremely soon, because you got 30 rounds firing off at 800 or 900 rounds per minute. It's an entirely different thing with the automatic shotguns, because you're only firing at 255 rounds per minute, which is considerably slower. But after having played around with this gun, and you definitely only want to use it in close quarters, your long range, you're just going to be outgunned by just about everything else on the battlefield. The slugs travel very slow, so hitting moving targets at longer ranges is incredibly hard to do. Your hip firing is really bad, your iron sights are really bad, so you really want to just keep it for mostly close quarters. The damage drop off with slugs and automatic shotguns is extreme. You will go all the way down to 37.5 at 50 meters, which means you're going to have to land multiple shots on your target at long ranges, and slugs drop extremely fast. The bullet drop is actually unrealistically fast when compared to other objects flying through the air. So they actually drop a lot faster, so you almost have to lob them at your targets at long range, which makes headshots increasingly difficult. Now, I did find that rather than going full auto with this weapon, it does make a lot of sense to sort of fire off each round individually, because you want to make sure those last. If you go full auto and you're tracking a target, sometimes your crosshair is just off target when your bullets fire, then you line up your target again and then it sort of judders to the side a little and your gun fires again, and you know you're mostly on target, but if you're just holding down, you can't control when the bullets fire. So sort of firing this as a semi-automatic weapon does make sense with slug rounds. The problem I found is that if you're gonna fire the weapon that way, you may as well use a different shotgun, like the Sega 12K. The reason for this is that although the Sega 12K fires at a slower RPM, which at 220, which doesn't seem to matter too much if you're gonna be firing it in more of a semi-automatic nature, the Sega has lesser recoil, greater aiming down sight accuracy, and a much faster reload time. It does lose one shot with extended mags, but I almost found that I never really went through all my shots when using extended mags. I often reloaded far before running out. So having a gun that can shoot a bit more accurately when aiming down sights and has a faster reload time seems to make much more sense for this kind of setup. I'm not saying that the Sega is a better overall gun than the MK3A1, but I am saying that for this particular setup with slug rounds and an auto shotty, the Sega would probably work a little bit better. Now, another thing that I would recommend if you're gonna run this setup is just put a stinking Cobra Sight on here. The Cobra Sight is really unencumbering, so it takes up a very small portion of your screen. And it will allow you to be that much more accurate when aiming down sights, which is something very important with this weapon because you have to land all your shots. If you miss just one or two shots on a quick peek, your opponent's going to gun you down. They're going to have AEKs, they're going to have M16s, they're going to have M416s, and those guns are very reliable. Even if they miss a shot or two when aiming at you, the rest are going to follow up and drop you incredibly fast. Overall, I think this is a very fun setup for close quarter combat. It's garbage at long range, so if you're looking to just change things up, have a bit of fun, I would recommend this setup, but definitely put a Cobra Sight on there, and if you want to do that semi-automatic firing, then swap out the MK3A1 for a Sega 12K. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Remember to leave a comment letting me know what you'd like me to run for next week, and I'll see you guys next time. This is Level Cap, signing off. Thank you.